In this video, we're gonna build a talking AI multi-agent from YouTube videos, a city trip expert using Crew AI LangChain, Llama & Llama, 11 Labs, Hugging Face, and it's gonna be for Amsterdam. First time travelers. I'm gonna explain everything step by step. Hi everyone, I am Maryam Miradi. I have a PhD in AI and 20 plus years experience applying AI in 12 different industries. And nowadays I train hundreds and hundreds of people to do the same. Check my training in the description and let's start. What are AI agents? They are basically software entities with a specific goal. So they perceive their environment, they decide based on what they received from their environment, any signals, any instructions, and then they act on it. And they can do it just by themselves or a number of them interacting together, collaborating together, multi-agents. Their task could be as simple as just a chatbot, just interaction, getting information, answering the questions. But it could be also as complex as self-driving cars. If we look at the building blocks of AI agents, nowadays we can use our pre-trained models from OpenAI or from Llama, Hugging Face. And then we can use the power of tools like Crew AI or LangChain to build on top of all of these large language models to chain all of the tasks that we need. And then you may want to add a little bit of memory. It means that you just store some information in a vector database, in a ChromaDB, in Face, any of the vector databases, it doesn't matter. Then we can search and retrieve those information. These are the building blocks of AI agents. So start simple and add pieces to that. Then you can build any kind of AI agent that you want. So we're going to build an AI agent for Amsterdam, first time travelers. And like everything in AI, we need data. Where can we get data for first time travelers? From YouTube. What I could do is now start with those YouTube videos and find their transcript. So let's start. So now we are in our Google Colab. We give some preferences, a maximum result of 20 videos, a minimum views of 10,000. We start searching our YouTube. What we need is a fetch YouTube video, and we use these libraries, the YouTube search Python, the YouTube transcript API. And what we do is we give a preference, which is our search query, and that's a travel guide in a specific city with that preference. And then we're going to search that and give it also a limit, kind of max result, and search that for each of the videos. Then we are going to parse the information, because views are given with a specific way, we need a bit of a replacement to make it actually a number. So we've got title, duration, views, channel, and the link of the channel. What we are doing from those 20 videos is looking at their minimum number of views. As you can see, a few of them are under 10,000, so we kind of filter that. Then in total, we have 16 videos. And then we store those information in a data frame by link on any of them. And you get this video, which is showing actually Amsterdam. Now we need to get the transcripts. To get the transcript, we use actually the YouTube URL. The link after this part is basically an ID of that YouTube, and then we can just find the YouTube transcript. So what we do is extract video IDs, just using that YouTube transcript API to get the transcript. And the transcripts either are there, or it can be it's disabled, no transcript found, or there is an error. So we cover all of these with try and accept, and then we can add actually the text to that video DF. Then if we run it, you can see for all of the 16 there is a transcript, so you can see actually the start of that YouTube video, and even says it's music. So now that we have our transcripts, we can continue with building our AI agent. So if we have the transcripts, then the logical step would be to just summarize them. But the problem is that the transcripts are very long, and they are not focused on one specific question that the traveler have, but more of a combination of a lot of them. So we want to narrow down that one, and we will do that by using DPR. putting our transcripts actually in a vector database using similarity base and searching for that specific passage that we want. So DPR, dense passage retrieval, is a method of retrieving relevant document or passages from a long corpus, particularly in the context of question answering tasks. This is where we want to ask these questions about our travel agency. Okay, so DPR works by learning dense vector representations, so our embeddings, of both questions and the passage. The goal is to embed questions and passages into the same high-dimensional vector space so that they are semantically similar. So basically, we will get similarities that are really close. So we have a component of question encoder and a component of passage encoder. How does it look like in our code? We start with a question encoder and a question tokenizer. Both of them, we are using actually the Facebook DPR question encoder. And for the passage encoder, we are using the Facebook DPR CTX encoder. So we built both of them. And these libraries are here, all of them from Transformer, from Hugging Face. And Face is the vector database that we are going to use. After building that, the first setup, we are going to encode our passage. What we do is use our transcripts. We are giving it to passage tokenize. We determine here, passage tokenizer. And then we give some maximum length and give the truncation is true, padding is true, do the embedding. Padding is when we want actually everything to be the same length, and then stack up all of the embedding together. So we have done the passage. This is our embedding. Having that, now we are going to go to Face. We're going to do the Face index to have the similarity search. Have it ready. We are going to go on a query tokenizer, build the query embedding. We are using the query encoder that we have determined here. This is the encoder, again from Hugging Face. And so we have the distance and indices. And we're going to make these retrieved passages from the title, the transcript, and the similarity score, and which indexes they are. So in other words, we're going to find the top two or three, say top K. This is the similarity score, the top three. My question was, what are the best museums in Amsterdam? From those 16 transcripts, it will give you the top three. So then you don't need to summarize all of those transcripts. It just gives the most relevant one which are there. Now that we have done the DPR and the vector databases and we could find actually the top similarities, we can go ahead and summarize the text with Llama using Olam. How does it look like in Google Colab in our code? Using a prompt, for example, we could say, become a travel guide and then generate these top 10 questions that a first-time traveler visiting city will ask. And then also just provide the questions without any description. We're building a small agent. For Olama, you need to do pip install Olama and pull Llama 3. It would gonna take a few minutes and we'll pull the whole Llama 3 to our notebook. Then we will get the response with Olama chat. We will say our model is the Llama 3, and then we can use the role and the content, which is our prompt. Then we can use actually a markdown to show it. Take a look at the questions. In general, the Llama 3 has shown to have really high quality. I've tried about 20 different LLMs and they came with not good top questions. So Llama 3 is a really good one. Especially using Olama, you basically can use it also locally. That's really the power of Olama. So the top 10 questions are, what is the best way to get around Amsterdam? Is Amsterdam safe to tourists? Or what are the must-see attractions? Can I drink the tap water in Amsterdam? How much money do I need for the budget for food and activities? Expensive, I will tell you. Can I bring my bike or rent one in Amsterdam. Don't bring your bike in Amsterdam. There are a lot of bikes here. Are there any unique experiences I should do when visiting Amsterdam? So these are really good questions that these YouTube videos will answer it. And a traveler needs to go through all of those questions to get answer. So building something completely automated can help anyone for a specific city. We can replace Amsterdam with any city and just get answers. That's a powerful part of automating this. I will show you 11 labs and text-to-speech in a bit, but I wanted to show you how to do this AI agent with Crew AI. The first tip that I want to give you is when you are installing Crew AI, choose this one, Crew AI tools, because if you install only Crew AI, it's a lot of dependencies, problems, and crashes. We need Llama, of course, because we're going to use Llama here. From Crew AI, we're going to import task, crew, process, agent, and LLM. And to use that local Llama, you need to say Llama/Llama, and then have this local host. If you don't do this small part, basically your code is not going to work. Then you're going to do some agents, so a couple of agents, and some tasks. What we are going to build is a crew of AIs, agents, which are generators, summarizer, and reviewer. The task would be to generate questions, summarize answers, and then review the output. And then the process needs to be sequential. Building agents with Crew AI is just very descriptive. So you will tell what's actually your role, what is now the goal. So give some background for that backstory. So why would you do that? What's the difference between this one and the one that I just generated? In that one, you're kind of using the one shot. And here we are using different agents that are checking each other. We have the travel expert, then we have the travel content reviewer. So if these two create something, content creator will look at the final markdown and wants to see if it's accurate, it's readable. Then we will kick off and we will put our results there. So it's really easy to build. And finally, we will print our result in a pretty bad color, to be honest, in green and magenta. We'll start with what are the best way to get around Amsterdam without a car. It's really good questions. Then travel expert will come with what are the best ways to get around Amsterdam without a car. The best way is using public transport, trams, bus, and metro line, which is completely right. The agent, the markdown, we will just check out all of the format. What I noticed though is with Llama is very slow. Answering this was about 20 minutes. I think if we use Grok, probably gonna be faster. But for now, we are just keeping it to this. So we have seen how to work with Crew AI and build those agents. And now we're gonna add 11 Lab as a talking part of the agent. I'm gonna use LangChain. We use LangChain community tools, 11 Labs, text to speech, and just import this one. You need to put your API here. To do so, go to 11labs.io, then log in. You can do it with your Gmail, then go to app, click on your name here at left, API key, and then you just can create a key. I've already made it, and then you can use that API key. And it will give you 10,000 credit for free. I've only used 11%, so it doesn't go very fast. Coming back, then I can put my 11 Labs API here. It's very straightforward. Then I will use TTS Ease, an 11 Lab text-to-speech tool. Then I will use the speech.run, so TTS.run. And my text-to-speech is whatever that I want to give. So I will pass from my previous agent, actually, my text. And then you will create a WAV file, and it will give you the path. So I saved it here, and if I run it.
Here are the top 10 questions that a first-time traveler might ask about visiting Amsterdam. Are there any unique or quirky experiences I should have while visiting Amsterdam?
The quality of the English is very well. And in my other video, I have tried it also with Dutch. You can actually have a multi-language, I think 25 different languages. Let's build a small agent. We have load tools here from the LangChain agents. So if you build agents with LangChain, one of the things Load Tools 11 Labs text-to-speech, agents initialize actually that agent, and then you give the LLM, and then you give agent whatever LLM that you like, and then and the agent type is basically structured chat, zero shot, react, description, and then we have verbose is true, and then you get exactly the same result. Video transcripts are actually text, they are pretty clean, it's just a lot, but imagine that you will have text, they are containing graphs and tables and unusual formats. You need actually to improve your retrieval augmented generation by using the right chunks, the right type of loader. So the video is packed with a lot of good information. Watch it and I will see you there.